All dear students, I am here with a video relating to capital gain. And in the previous video also, in the end I said something but it was not properly audible, not recorded properly. I said only one thing, that only few people are watching the revision videos. I hope these revision videos will be helpful for you all. That is why I am making these videos. As you people have studied for the exams, but exams because of COVID situation postponed, so you people might have not revised the syllabus. So that is why I am making the revision video for you all. And if you people watch these videos, you people can easily do the problems in the exam. And one more thing I said, before doing the problems, please learn the provisions or go through the provisions once. If you learn the provisions, go through the provisions relating to the income tax, so that you can solve the problem. Otherwise you will not able to solve the problem perfectly. And if you learn the provisions, one more thing is what, why for writing theory answer also, you can write the provision as it is and you will get the marks. So two benefits: one, you can write the theory question, and other thing, you can solve the problem. So that is what I said. And even if not all of you view the video, watch the video, no problem. Even one student get the benefit of these videos, that will be enough for me. That is what I said. Okay, let us go to the question relating to this. And I am expecting a question from this area, so that is why I am making this video. Stamp duty value related question. Generally I have explained one question relating to this. In connection with stamp duty value, one more question will be there: determination of full value of consideration as per section 50C. Okay, capital asset being land and building. In the question, if they said asset is land or building or both, and that is transferred during the previous year, and where stamp duty value is also given. If stamp duty value is not given, no problem. If stamp duty value is given, then full value of consideration will be determined as follows. If stamp duty value is given in the question, first we will see 105% of sale value of consideration. 105% of sale value of consideration. Suppose sale value is 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs into 105% in the calculator you do. Okay, that value and the stamp duty value. If stamp duty value exceeds 105% of sale value of consideration, then full value of consideration is stamp duty value. If stamp duty value is less than the 105% of sale value of consideration, then full value of consideration will be equal to sale value of consideration, not stamp duty value. What you wrote, ma? Sale value of consideration. If it is less than stamp duty value, then stamp duty value is less, then we need to consider full value of consideration as sale value of consideration. In this example itself, what I said, 10 lakhs is the sale value of consideration. आपने एक बिल्डिंग है, वो बिल्डिंग को कितने में सेल करें, 10 लाख में सेल करें. 105% ऑफ सेल वैल्यू, 5% मीन्स 10 लाख, 10,50,000 विल बी योर 105% ऑफ 105% ऑफ सेल वैल्यू ऑफ कंसिडरेशन. एंड इफ स्टैम्प ड्यूटी वैल्यू गिवन इज 12 लाख, स्टैम्प ड्यूटी वैल्यू इज हाउ मच, स्टैम्प ड्यूटी वैल्यू गिवन इज 12 लाख. Is 12 lakhs is more than the 10,50,000? Yes. So your full value of consideration while calculating. First thing we will write now, full value of consideration will be stamp duty value, that is 12 lakhs. Suppose stamp duty value is only 9 lakhs. How much? 9 lakhs. Okay. Then stamp duty value is less than the 105% of full value of consideration. Then full value of consideration will be sale value of consideration. How much you have sold? For 10 lakhs you have sold, that we will take. Clear? Clear? That's it. Our stamp duty value is 10 lakh 20,000. Stamp duty value is 10 lakh 20,000, but you have sold for 10 lakhs. Sale value is 10 lakhs. Sale value of consideration. But stamp duty value given in the question is, stamp duty value given in the question is 20 lakhs. 20,000 extra. Stamp duty value 10 lakh 20,000. So 105% is how much? 10 lakh 50,000. Is 10 lakh 50,000 is more and stamp duty value is less. In this case, full value of consideration will be sale value of consideration, that is 10 lakhs. That is 10 lakhs. That's it. This is how we need to do. Again, along with this, sometimes in the question, they will include one more point. Till yesterday, we did problem till here. Now, in this case itself, they will include one more point. In case there is a dispute regarding the stamp duty value by the assessee and assessing officer. Okay, assessing officer or assessee, okay, dono ke beech mein dispute hai regarding the stamp duty value. Then assessing officer will appoint another person called valuation officer. Wo aa jayega. When valuation officer is appointed, this valuation officer will value the value of the asset. In this case, if stamp duty value is greater than 105% of sale value of consideration, then generally what? Then full value of consideration equals to stamp duty value. But when valuation officer is appointed, we need to check full value of consideration as stamp duty value or valuation officer value. Whichever is less, that will be your full value of consideration. Suppose valuation officer is saying stamp duty value is 12 lakhs. Valuation officer is saying 11 lakhs is the value of the asset. Asset is sold at 10 lakhs. Okay, same. This 10 lakhs is the sale value. This is the 12 lakhs stamp duty value. This value as per valuation officer value. So, whichever is lower, 12 lakhs or 11 lakhs, which one is less? 11 lakhs is the less. So 11 lakhs will be considered for the value as full value of consideration. Suppose valuation officer is saying 15 lakhs and stamp duty value is 12 lakhs. Which one is less? 12 lakhs is less. That will be considered for the full value of consideration. This is the point given. So let us see one question relating to this. So that is what I am saying. When you are clear with the provision, we can do the problem easily. Otherwise, you can't do the problem easily. So this is whole provision. Now let us see the question. In your textbook, there is a question relating to this concept in page number A72. Question number 14 is the question relating to this concept. So let us do the problem relating to this. 14th question. On 1st July 2018, Sri Praveen transferred a flat for agreed consideration of 20 lakhs to Shivani and selling expenses 10,000. What is the sale value? Is 20 lakhs. Okay. And transfer expenses that we will deduct. He purchased on January 2013. Asset is what? Flat. Flat means immovable property. In case of immovable property, if it is exceeds 24 months से ज़्यादा or 2 years से ज़्यादा है तो long term capital gain. Period of holding POHA exceeding 2 years, 2013 to 2018 means more than 2 years, so it is a long term capital asset. One thing. The next thing, in case of flat, that is immovable property or land or building, these are immovable properties. In this case, cost of inflation index for 12-13 is 200, for 18-19 is 280. Compute income from capital gain in the following situations. What I said? In case of land or building or flat, stamp duty value is given. In situation 1, they are saying stamp duty value is how much? 23 lakhs. In situation 1, in following situations you do is it. In situation 1, stamp duty value is how much? 23 lakhs. What is the sale value? 20 lakhs is your sale value. 20 lakhs into 105%. If you have a calculator, please do the calculation along with me. How much it will be? 20 lakhs into 105%, it will become 105% will become 21 lakhs, isn't it? So 21 lakhs is the 105% of stamp duty value, sorry, sale value. 105% of sale value of consideration. Sale value of consideration of 105%, 21 lakhs. What is the stamp duty value? Stamp duty value 23 lakhs. 23 lakhs. 23 lakhs is greater than, that is, stamp duty value is greater than 105% of sale value of consideration. Then full value of consideration equals to stamp duty value, that will be 23 lakhs simply. So till here, yesterday also we did, now also I am saying the same thing. Sale value of consideration is stamp duty value. Okay, situation 1 is over. Situation 1, till here we have discussed situation 1. So let us do the problem with the solution here. So first we will do the working notes. Working note 1, full value of consideration that we are doing here. Full value of consideration. Calculation of full value of consideration as per section 50C, immovable property, when stamp duty value is given in the question. Consideration will be if stamp duty value is exceeding 105% of sale value of consideration, then full value of consideration is stamp duty value. 23 lakhs and 21 lakhs. 20 lakhs into 105%. So full value of consideration 23 lakhs. Next working note 2. cost of acquisition. Asset is acquired after 1/4/2001. In 2003 they have acquired. So in 2012 acquired. They said 2013 they have purchased. So indexed cost of acquisition is equals to cost of purchase, cost of acquisition, into CII of transfer year divided by CII of purchase year. So cost of acquisition given in the question, 5 lakhs into 280 divided by 100. 7 lakhs is indexed cost of acquisition. Okay, we have got full value of consideration, we have got indexed cost of acquisition. Let us see the answer in situation 1. In situation 1, our answer will be like this. Okay. In situation 1, answer will be like this. Okay. Computation of income from capital gain of Mr. Praveen for the assessment year 1920, situation 1 we are doing. Particulars, rupees. Full value of consideration as per section 50C, working note 1, 23 lakhs stamp duty value, and selling expenses given in the question, 10,000 deducted, net consideration 22,90,000. Then indexed cost of acquisition, this is working note 2, we have just saw 7 lakhs as working note. Long term capital gain before exemption 15,90,000. From 22 lakhs, if you deduct 7 lakhs, it will be 15,90,000. Exemption under section 54 not given, so no, nil. Taxable long term capital gain 15,90,000. Till here, no problem. Situation 1 is over. Okay, let us see the situation 2. Situation 2, what does situation 2 is saying? So situation 1 is over. Situation 2, if stamp duty value is 24 lakhs, he claims the assessing officer that 24 lakhs is more than the fair market value of the land. Us jagah pe jahan pe building hai, us value se fair market value, आजू बाजू में कोई भी 20 लाख से ज्यादा नहीं सेल करे बोल के, कौन बोल रहे? असेसी सिंह. द असेसिंग ऑफिसर रिफर्स टू वैल्यूएशन ऑफिसर हु डिटरमाइंस वैल्यू 23,50,000 एज फेयर मार्केट वैल्यू. उस जगह पे मार्केट वैल्यू लैंड की कितना है सेल करने के लिए बोले तो 23,50,000. हु इज सेइंग? वैल्यूएशन ऑफिसर वैल्यू इज सेइंग. So in this case, as we saw, stamp duty value is exceeding the 105% of sale value. 20 lakhs 105% of sale consideration से stamp duty value ज्यादा है. मगर assessee क्या बोल रहा, आप जो stamp duty value बोल रहे हैं, that is more than the, this 24 lakhs is more than the लोकल एरिया conditions. सो उन्होंने वैल्यूएशन ऑफिसर को बोले, वैल्यूएशन ऑफिसर ने बोला यहाँ पे लैंड वैल्यू सेल के लिए 23,50,000 है. नाउ वी हैव टू सी फुल वैल्यू ऑफ कंसिडरेशन. फुल वैल्यू ऑफ कंसिडरेशन विल बी इक्वल्स टू ए स्टैंड ड्यूटी वैल्यू और B valuation officer value, whichever is lower. अब stamp duty value कितना है? Stamp duty value है आपका 24 lakhs. In situation 2 I am saying 24 lakhs. And valuation officer value 23,50,000. दोनों में से कौन सा कम है? Which one is low? This 23,50,000 is less. I'll write properly 23,50,000. So this 23,50,000 is less. So full value of consideration will be 23,50,000 only, not 24 lakhs. Let us go to the problem. First situation 2. Situation 2. Let us see the answer. In remaining question, remaining every part is same, only these two consider things are changed. Consider these two are changed. Stamp duty value 24 lakhs, valuation officer value 23,50,000. Which one is less? 23,50,000 is less. So we will consider 23,50,000 as full value of consideration and solve the problem. So situation working note 1, first situation 2, full value of consideration as per section 50C in case of immovable property when stamp duty value given and there is dispute by the assessing officer and valuation officer is appointed. Full value of consideration will be, if stamp duty value is less than 105% of sale value of consideration, full value of consideration is sale value of consideration. If less than, if stamp duty value is more than 105% of sale value of consideration, then full value of consideration will be stamp duty value or valuation officer value, whichever is lower. So in this case, see here, in this case stamp duty value and 105% of sale value of consideration, stamp duty value 24 lakhs and valuation officer value sale value of consideration into 105% will become 21 lakhs. Which one is more? This one is more. In this case full value of consideration will be a stamp duty value or valuation officer value, whichever is lower. 24 lakhs or 23,50,000, this one is less, 23,50,000 we will consider. First situation 2. For situation 2. So answer in situation 2 will be like this. Computation of income from capital gain of Praveen for the assessment year 1920, particulars rupees. Full value of consideration working note 1 23,50,000 and less transfer expenses 10,000. So net consideration 23,40,000. From that indexed cost of acquisition working note 2 said here in situation 1, long term capital gain before exemption 16,40,000 and exemption taxable long term capital gain 16,40,000. Let us see the situation 3. In situation 3, what they are saying? If stamp duty value is 24 lakhs, he claims the assessing officer that 24 lakhs is the more than the fair market value of the land. The assessing officer refers to the valuation officer who determines as 25,25,000 as the fair market value. Stamp duty value is 24 lakhs, fair market value is 25,25,000. In this case, what I said? A or B? Stamp duty value or valuation officer value? Whichever is less. So 24 lakhs or 25,25,000, whichever is less, that should be considered. So here we consider 24 lakhs as the full value of consideration. When this will be? If stamp duty value is greater than 105 percentage of sale value of consideration. If it is less than sale value of consideration, then sale value of consideration will be your full value of consideration. So here let us go to the question again. Answer in situation 3. So this is one of the important question, that is why I am explaining in revision video also. Okay, so situation 3, we are dealing situation 3, calculation of full value of consideration as per section 50C immovable property when stamp duty value is given and there is a dispute by the assessee and valuation officer is appointed. Full value of consideration will be if stamp duty value is less than the 105 percentage of sale value of consideration, then full value of consideration will be sale value of consideration. If stamp duty value exceeds 105 percentage of sale value of consideration, then stamp duty value or valuation officer value, whichever is lower, will be full value of consideration. That is what I said. So stamp duty value, if exceeds stamp duty value and full value of 105 percentage of sale value of consideration, 24 lakhs and 21 lakhs. Okay, full value of consideration will be A, stamp duty value, B, valuation officer value, whichever is less. So 24 lakhs or 25 lakhs, 25,000, which one is less? 24 lakhs is the less. Full value of consideration, 24 lakhs. Let us do the calculation. Computation of capital gain. Capital gain of Mr. Sri Praveen for the assessment year 1920, particulars, rupees. Full value of consideration, working note 1, just now we did 24 lakhs, less expenses, transfer expenses. Net consideration will be 23 lakhs 90 thousand, and indexed cost of acquisition we did in working note 2 for the situation 1, that only will be 7 lakhs. So put it in brackets. If you put it in bracket, it means that you are deducting. Long term capital gain before exemption 16,90,000. Exemption is not given. So long term capital gain taxable will be 16,90,000. This is how we need to do the problem. So here I'll have completed the entire question relating to the capital gain with the stamp duty value. This is the most typical one. Other than this, he will not give any other tricky thing with the stamp duty value. So here is the answer for question number 14. This notes link will be provided in the description, so you can find the answer from there, and in your notes also it is available. You can check it out from your notes also. So here is the answer for the, this is how you need to do. So I'll tell one theory part which will be I'm expecting to come in the exam. Previously 2 years back or 2 attempts back, there was a question relating to it. I'll give the answer also for this. Sometimes in the exam he is asking capital gain exemptions under section 10. exemption under section 54, you know, exemption under section 54, you know, 54, 54B, 54D, 54EC, 54F, EE, 54G, GA, GB, like that. 54 series is there that we have discussed also. Other than that, sometimes he is asking, 2 years back also he has asked exemption under section 10. He will ask for explain the exemptions under section 50, under section 10. Previously he gave for 12 marks. Now marks have been increased, so you may get for 15 marks. So what you need to write, what is capital gain means, meaning a definition, and what are included in the capital asset and what are not included in the capital asset, so that your answer what will become more. And exemptions under section 10 are, one, under section 1033, any income arising from transfer of capital asset being units of unit scheme under section under scheme 1964 of UTI, and any income received on transfer of units of business trust that is any income not long term capital gain you can say long term capital gain on transfer of units of business trust is exempted under section 10. And one more point here, we are having where any individual or HUF who owns urban agriculture land which has been used for agriculture purpose for a period of 2 years immediately preceding to the date of transfer of such asset, okay, by individual or by his parents or by HUF, same is compulsorily acquired under any law or the consideration for such transfer is determined by the central government or RBI, resultant capital gain will be exempt. This is compulsorily acquired. Not all urban agriculture lands are exempt. Urban agriculture land is compulsorily acquired by the state government or central government under any law, and where consideration is determined by central government and RBI, then such capital gain will be exempt. Consideration of such transfer is received after 1/4/2004. This provision has inserted after 1/4/2004. So that is what the meaning. And amount received by senior citizen as a loan, either in lump sum or installment, in the transactions of reverse mortgage would be exempt from income tax. I said this one as an example while doing the exemptions under section 10 relating to semester 3 also. That is nothing but where a senior citizen is there, he is having a building, no one is there, unke bache koi bhi nahi hai, hai lekin unke dekhbhal nahi kar rahe. In that case, this land or building, whatever is there, will be, that senior citizen will transfer to a bank or cooperative society which is dealing the banking activity, and that bank in turn will give some lump sum amount or annual payments in installment, lump sum or annual payments every year or monthly payments. Whatever income is receiving from the bank is not taxable as capital gain because he is transferring the land and building to bank. As a security, he will mortgage. This scheme is called reverse mortgage scheme. I explained this point previously also. So, if any senior citizen as a loan or lump sum amount of installment received under the reverse mortgage will be exempt under section 1043. This is one more point. There is one more thing. It is in your textbook also. Page number I don't know. But related provision I will explain. I have some notes. You can take the screenshot of this, or you can see in your textbook also relating to this point. One, I said just now, this point I didn't set. This is new point inserted. So any transfer upon buyback of unlisted shares of a domestic company shall be exempt in the hands of shareholder as per section 1034A. You are transferring the shares to domestic company, and company will give some consideration that is not regarded, that whatever you have received, that is not a capital gain and it is not taxable in the hands of shareholder. Okay, it is treated as deemed dividend and will be taxable in the hands of company. Company has to pay DDT on that. So leave that is not matter for you. You just remember till this here. And 1043 reverse mortgage I have explained. 1037 compulsory acquisition of urban agriculture land as a CE is individual or HUF. They should, or their parents, use it for agriculture purpose, and it should be compulsory acquisition and received after 2004. These are the points just now I explained. And 37A, transfer of land or building or both, okay, after 2012 under the Andhra Pradesh capital city land pooling scheme. This is newly inserted provision. This is nothing but for the purpose of making the capital city Amaravati in the Andhra Pradesh, lands of farmers and other people have been taken. So whatever as a compensation people are receiving, that will not be treated as capital gain. So special provision has been inserted. Assessee is individual or HUF, owns a land or building under the Andhra Pradesh capital city land pooling scheme, they have been taken. Ownership certificate is issued under the scheme. Any capital gain on account shall be exempt. Okay, this is in your textbook also. So I am expecting this question as a theory question to you all. So that is why I explained this point. So that's it. Aaj ke liye itna hi. Bahut zyada ho gaya. Phir milenge. So one theory question, one problem I have explained. Find 2-3 questions relating to exempted incomes we will do, so that you can solve the problems. That's it. Seekhna ban to jeetna ban. Seekhte raho jeetne ke liye. And before doing the problems, please go through the provisions. For provisions, part 1, part 2, part 3, 3 videos I have made. Actually, I want to make one video. It has become 3 videos. So, see those also, and all the remaining also. Okay. Jai Hind.